destiny carefully etched in the record books, it's now time to look ahead to the games in Athens, just a little more than 3 years away. The stars of the next games have already begun crafting their performances for the future. Some new stars, as well as some familiar faces, have gathered today in Paris for World Cup gymnastics competition. Celebrex presents World Cup Gymnastics from Paris, France. Welcome to the 2001 French International Gymnastics Competition. Hi everyone, I'm Bart Connor along with Nadia Comaneci. This World Cup event is the first major gymnastics event of the 2001 season, which culminates at the World Championships in October in Belgium. And today, Nadia, we have a fantastic field, including some familiar faces as well as some new ones.
The double Olympic champion from Russia, Elena Zamolochikova, looks great. With her explosive power, she's one of the hottest gymnasts right now. Joining her here is her teammate from Russia, Basnik. She also won 3 medals in Sydney. She looks very stylish and she will debut a new floor routine here in Paris.
Now, after the Olympics, the judges changed the rules, requiring higher standards and essentially raised the bar. Today we're going to talk a lot about the new code of points, the new rules, and how these athletes are dealing with them.
The new rules are much harder than they were in Sydney. That's why we will see much lower scores. A routine that might have worth a 9.7 or 9.8 in Sydney, it may score here only a 9.3 or 9.4 under the new rules.
And today we're also going to take a look at International Gymnast Magazine's Rising Stars feature. We're going to go to the World Olympic Gymnastic Academy in Plano, Texas, where many of America's future stars are being developed. In an unusual order of events today, we're going to start with the balance beam. First up, Estelle Corriveau from France. She's 16 years old, just stepped up this year to the senior ranks.
This is an aerial walkover. Not the best I've seen. We will see more gymnasts doing this move because it's worth 110 bonus.
Watch this sequence coming up here.
Beautiful and very difficult combination.
I mentioned that today we're seeing an unusual order of competition in order to accommodate the men's meet as well as a power tumbling competition that's going on at the same time. They're going out of order with the normal. Oh!
That's a major mistake. She will get half of a point deduction for this.
Same deduction as if she were to completely fall off, but you certainly show the judges some grit by being willing to hang on. We'll talk all day long about the new rules and some of the new challenges to the gymnast. Higher level of difficulty is demanded this year.
And great form for this dismount.
Perhaps some nerves in her first major senior meet.
Here's where she had troubles. You can see her right shoulder is very close to the beam that throws her entire body to the side. Still hanging.
There's her coach, Véronique Legras. 9.5 was her start value based on her difficulty, 8.325, the final score for that performance. Song Xiao Zhao, the 16-year-old from China. She is gorgeous on this event, Nadia.
And Bart, she is the only gymnast with a 10-0 start value on this event. Beautiful handstand. This is one of the new requirements. It's a 2-second hold position.
She has a nice combination coming up here.
Wow, and unusual.
Now, Nadia, she did not make the 2000 Olympic team for the Chinese, so perhaps the fact that while they were training under the old code, she was working some new skills to accommodate this new level of difficulty.
But this is the impression that I got. I mean, she feels unbelievably comfortable with this routine.
Clean execution. good finish on all those leaps and jumps. We've come to expect such technical precision from the Chinese gymnast.
Wow. That's a blind skill. Here comes the dismount. A double back. Not bad at all.
Certainly a high level of difficulty and clean execution throughout. That should get a big score. This is an unusual mount. It's a simple move, but a very clever way to get onto the beam.
And this is the same move that Cori Vo did, but she executed with excellent technique.
And watch the reach on this double back. Very good lift to set up the rotation. And a pretty clean landing. So out of a 10.0 start value, 9.725 for Sung Xiao Zhao. When we come back, more on the balance beam, including Olympic gold medalist Yelena Zamolochikova. The 2001 French International is presented by Celebrex. Talk to your doctor about Celebrex. Back inside now, the Palais Omnisport de Bercy. On the balance beam, Esther Moya, the 16-year-old from Spain, was a member of the fifth-place team at the Olympics in Sydney. Nadia, she's very well known for her explosive, powerful tumbling, vaulting, and occasionally she's powerful on the beam, like this move.
A little off, but she corrected. This is a new jump for her. It's a tourjeté half. Oh. She didn't quite get around.
Another example of the gymnast adjusting to a higher level of difficulty. If she makes that successfully, it's worth 0.2 of a point.
A little off here too. It seems to me that this is the same skeleton of a routine that she competed with last year. Just she added a few new skills to update the new code.
Much different style from Sung Xiao Xiao, our leader. This is more choppy, but a great dismount, 2.5 twister. I like this mount, Nadia.
And this is a Silivash. It's named after Daniela Silivash, the Romanian gymnast who first executed this mount.
This is the powerful front somersault. We're going to see a lot of these in combination to get bonus points under the new code.
And this is a dismount, a 2.5 twist, blind landing. She's got no problem.
9.4, the start value for her difficulty rating of that routine, 8.55, so much lower than the scores we saw last year at the Olympics in Sydney, for sure. Here is one of the reigning stars of the sport, Yelena Zamolochikova. She won 3 medals at the Olympics in Sydney, 2 of them gold. And right away, she's working on a combination here, which she has practiced at least 100 times in warm-up. Let's see if she makes it. A little shaky, but she made it. Interesting contrast in styles from the other athletes in the finals. Her rhythm much more like Moya's, very staccato. See that move there? That's called a V. Another one of those hold requirements.
She was a little off. I assumed that she was trying to connect this with the back and spring full straddle down. I guess this didn't happen this time.
Now this is interesting. You hear the crowd in the background applauding to the music Zorba. That's not from a floor routine. It just happens to be background music in the building. Doesn't seem to be phasing her.
And great dismount.
Nice, high, powerful double back at the end.
And this is a beautiful switch leap in a three-quarter shushu nova.
This dismount, she can do it sometimes even with a full twist, but she reaches her arms up and keeps her knees together. Good form on that double back. And a 9.5 start value, so a score of 9.1 for Yelena Zamolochikova. So the final results of the women's balance beam competition, Sung Xiao Zhao with a 9.725 dominates. Fifth place was Estelle Corriveau from France. When we come back, we're going to go to the women's uneven bars, and we'll take a look at the high-flying sport of tumbling. What is that, you ask? Well, it's a lawnmower. How else would you cut the grass if the walls of the building were made of it? Only in Paris, France, at the 2001 French International at the Palais Omnisports de Bercy. Now, gymnastics fans are going to love this. The sport of tumbling has been around for many years. The first world championships were held in the 60s, where Americans like Judy Wills dominated. But today, the sport is high-tech. This is Yelena Bluzhina of Russia, the two-time world champion. From a 33-foot runway to an 85-foot-long super springy tumbling strip made of fiberglass rods and foam, the best tumblers in the world came to Paris to compete. The medalists were determined by a combination score of two different runs. Mariama Ndour of France, she earned the silver medal. The silver for the men went to France's Nicolas Fournial. The women's gold medal went to Christel Robert of France. With this combination, laid out double somersault, through to a pike double somersault. And the gold for the men went to 30-year-old former world champion Alexei Krianovsky. Watch this, full in triple back. In a sport that is sure to gain popularity quickly, when you watch the double layout through to two whips, to a back handspring. Now count him, after this back handspring, he goes up with a full and two more somersaults to complete a full twisting triple. Oh man, you have to have cast iron knees to land that. That was great. Do you like that, Nadia?
It was awesome.
All right, back to artistic gymnastics now. Estelle Corriveau from France. Already a fifth place performance on the balance beam. This is a very good event for her.
She has beautiful body position.
Nice combination right there in the release. Good execution.
And a little over-rotated here. If you're not careful, you can end up in your rear end on the mat.
Nice combination of inverted giant swings to the dismount, a double front. This is a fantastic combination here. She's in the inverted or eagle grip position, and she does an endo, which is a straddle giant swing.
And she connected with a high release move.
Here's another look at the hop, full pirouette back to the eagle grip position. Nice technique. She followed it up with a double front somersault out of that eagle grip. The score for Estelle Corriveau from a 9.6 start value and 8.9. Next up is the 25-year-old mother of a 2-year-old son, Oksana Chusovitina. 10 years ago, she was a world champion, and she's still a major contender today. This This move right here, the hop full pirouette, is named after her. Good combination.
I really admire that she's out there not only competing but trying to keep pace with the new cut of points.
It's a real tribute to her fitness level. Really strong and nice technique on this dismount.
Not bad for a mama.
How often do you see a contender? She's also a mother. 25-year-old Oksana Chusovitina. Nice transition.
And great body position.
This is the full pirouette. And this second one, the hop full pirouette, is the move that's named after her.
And what's very interesting is that she wears no handguards.
Doesn't seem to affect her in these giant swings. She has good grip, very high. Full twisting double back. 9-4, the start value, 8.825 for Chusovitina. When we come back, more competition on the uneven bars with China's Sung Xiaozhao. And welcome back to Montmartre in the hills overlooking Paris and the majestic towers of Sacré-Cœur. The uneven bars competition continues now with Sung Xiaozhao. She won the balance beam earlier today.
Wow, great technique is always there.
We have just come to expect the mastery of technique, the Chinese on the bars as well as the balance beam. Beautiful work in those inverted giant swings.
Beautiful release move, really high. Comes a dismount, wow.
A little short.
No, you're right, Bart.
I think she ran out of gas there on that dismount. Under the new rules, we'll see more elements on the low bar from the gymnast. In the past, the gymnast only touched the low bar to get up to the high bar to do the more complicated skills.
Watch this great release move. Has great height. And look at the form.
Beautiful body position throughout. It appears that her conditioning is a little lacking because she didn't quite have enough rotation on this full twisting double back. And so from a start value of 9-6, the score for Sung Xiaozhao, 8-9-5. This is 15-year-old Verona Vandeleur of the Netherlands. She is great on the bars.
That's a pretty low release move.
This is a good combination here. Coming on the low bar.
Beautiful body position.
She won the bronze medal in this building a year ago at the Junior European Championships. This is a big senior event for her.
Wow, double-double. Great dismount. She missed the mat.
Talk about this combination on the low bar. In the eagle grip, she does two endos or straddle giant swings forward and pirouettes out. Once again, showing more elements on the low bar than in the last coat of points.
And this is the ginger, but very low for her.
But that is also a requirement that the gymnast under the new code have to do a release move that lets go and catches the same bar.
And this is a double-double dismount that she puts her hand down. That will cost her.
But with the high level of difficulty, a 10-0 start value, Verona Vandeleur gets 9.3, and she is our winner today in Paris. Chusovitina was 4. Coming up, we're going to go back to the United States for a look at one of America's hottest gymnastics programs in Plano, Texas. Before we continue with the 2001 French International, it's time to bring you our International Gymnast Magazine's Rising Stars. Today, we travel back to the United States to what was once an abandoned Montgomery Ward store in Plano, Texas. It's now the home to many of America's top young gymnasts. The World and Olympic Gymnastic Academy, or WOGA, as it is known in the gymnastics community, is the realization of a dream of two former Russian gymnastics champions. Yevgeny Marchenko, the five-time world champion in sports acrobatics, and European World and Olympic gold medalist Valery Liukin started their own training center to create American champions. Right away, Liukin and Marchenko realized there were some big differences between the American and Russian systems.
That was a challenge, but as soon as we start live inside the culture, and every year we just open more and more advantages, you know. And I think by putting things together, our thoughts and ideas, we were able to keep kids motivated. Even with so many, like I said, things around, our girls is just extremely motivated. They love what we're doing. We're working as hard as any Russian girl, even harder, I think.
So whatever he does, I don't even question. And the same thing from him. If I do something, that means we need that. Not I need that, we need that. I trust him 100% and he trusts me 100%.
WOGA is one of America's hottest programs with 200 team members who challenge each other every day.
I think it's good because we all kind of push each other. Like someone who has a skill and they're like, oh, that's cool, and you want to try it yourself. So we kind of help each other to get better at everything.
Oh, Nikki, sweet girl, that a girl, beautiful.
Okay, next step, Leah.
You see, when your brain works, how good you can do, eh?
WOGA is currently the home of seven junior international elite team members who, like their coaches, have very high goals for themselves.
Just to be the best I can be. I mean, of course, I want to make, you know, world championships, Olympics.
Well, we wish them all good luck at the WOGA program in Plano, Texas. I'm sure it won't be long before we'll be seeing them compete for the United States in major international competitions like this. Now to the floor exercise, Ekaterina Lobozniak. Three-time medalist from the Games in Sydney. Nadia, this is a new floor routine. Well, what do you think?
I think I liked it. Interesting, complex, a little bizarre.
I liked it. Now, here's a young lady who was born in Uzbekistan. Her hometown is in Siberia. She's coached by her mother in Moscow. She has it all.
And this is her first pass. It's a double layout. Just a little hop on the landing.
Here's an interesting point relating to the new rules. This tumbling pass in the last quadrennium was worth a half a point. Now it's only worth 1/10 of a point bonus.
And this is a great pass. It's worth 2/10 if she makes it all the way around.
On that front 2.5 twister. And with a start value of 9.6, 9.125 for Lobozniak, pretty good score these days. That brings up Yelena Zamolochikova, the reigning Olympic champion on this event. This is the same music that she used in Sydney. And this routine is a treat.
Wow, seems out of bounds. Can't tumble anymore. She's got one more run. Full twisting double. Take that, judges. With her guns blazing. This is her first pass. It's a double-double. And Bart, this is the best I've seen her doing this. Great height, great direction, great landing.
Now it looks as if the judges raised the red flag twice for her going out of bounds, but look at this pike double back somersault. She does step back, but it doesn't appear that her heel touches down outside of the area for the deduction.
Yeah, it didn't look like that, Bart, but take a look at this pass. It's 1.5 into a triple twist, and it looks totally that she's landing on a yellow part of the floor, which is outside.
Well, looks like she's aiming for the line judge with this one. Take that, buddy. So the score, a 9.175 out of a 9.8 start value for the Olympic champion. More floor exercise action here in France when we come back. Don't go away. A gorgeous day in Paris as gymnastics competition on Fox Sports Net continues at the 2001 French International. We turn our attention now on the floor exercise to 15-year-old Verona Vandeleur. Nice exercise. Vandeleur is 15 years old. She'll be 16 on the 27th of December. So just by 5 days, she's age eligible for the World Championships this year, meaning she turns 16 by the end of the year.
And this is the first pass that she performed. It's a full-in double pike, which is pretty good for a tall gymnast. This is a very important pass that comes now. Is a whip into a triple twist.
Start value and bonus points, so important. This is a handspring laid out front with a double twist, a little bobble on the landing. But she is trying to do the high level of tumbling difficulty to get a good score. 9.5 her start value, 8.8 her final score. Well, you talk about strong tumblers, you have to talk about this young lady, Oksana Chusovitina, the 25-year-old former world champion on this event back in 1991.
So easy.
I love this second pass. For Chusovitina, some big individual tumbling skills, not necessarily skills in combination, but some big moves like this double layout.
This is a very dynamic floor routine, and it enhances her power. Watch this double layout, it's so high.
I like the second tumbling pass. This is a double back with a full twist. It's called a full out because the full twist is done in the second flip right there. She tucks and finishes that extra twist. Very clean. 9.6 start value. So for Chusovitina, 8.975 her score on the floor. So here are the final results in the floor exercise competition. Zamolochikova, the Olympic champion, reigns again in Paris. Vandeleur was fourth. The women will be up on the vault when we come back, and we'll take a look at the men's competition featuring American Sean Townsend. Welcome back to the 2001 French International Gymnastics Competition. There was also a men's meet here this week in Paris, and the Americans were well represented by Blaine Wilson and Sean Townsend. On the rings, there was a classic battle for the medals, with Wilson starting off with a strong 9.525. But it was Sean Townsend who got a big moral victory over Blaine Wilson, who normally overshadows Townsend. Clean execution gave Townsend a 9.55 in the bronze medal in this event. The battle for the gold was also a tight one between two predictable contenders. Jordan Yovchev of Bulgaria showed a new strength combination for him. But it was the Olympic gold medalist, Sylvester Csolani from Hungary, who won again, and this time by just 25 thousandths of a point, with his trademark precise body positions. He scored a 9.8. On the pommel horse, it was Olympic champion Marius Urzica who was untouchable. It seems no matter what the rules are, Urzica has the stuff to score well. His 9.75 in this event was more than 0.4 of a point ahead of second place. The Romanians got another gold medal on the vault, Marian Dragulescu, who performed an amazing handspring double front with a half to secure the title with a 9.562 average. on the high bar. It was Aljas Pagan from Slovenia who used his signature move, a double front with a half twist over the bar. He followed that up with a combination of three release moves in a row. His score, 9-6-5, was good enough for first place. On the floor, it was Gervasio de Fer of Spain who used combinations like that to score 9-6-2-5 and earn the gold. Then on the parallel bars, it was Francis Jan Kucherat who did a clean routine with a variety of skills to earn gold. 9.65 was his score. The success of the American Sean Townsend continued as he earned his second medal of the day with this routine on the parallel bars. After a slight break in rhythm on this extremely difficult exercise right here, the rest of the routine was clean. His score, 9.5, was good enough for silver and some valuable experience.
Yeah, well, it's really important for all the Americans to get out here and get exposure to these European events because in the long run, it's going to pay off at Worlds, so hopefully we can keep it up.
Next up, the women's vault competition. Normally, we start a meet with vault, but today, because of this unusual order of competition, we're going to finish the competition for the women on the vault, and that will bring up Oksana Chusovitina. Had a good day so far, fourth on the bars, third on the floor exercise. And this typically, Nadia, is a strong event for her.
She's a very powerful gymnast.
Amazing to see her still competing at such a high level. This vault will be a handspring tucked front somersault with a full twist.
Wow, that was a great push from the horse. The value of this vault is 9.60. Let's take a look at the replay. Great push and great form. Look at the knees are together. Just a hop on the landing.
She lands a good distance from the horse and in line, 9.2, the score for that ball. As you mentioned, a 9.6 start value, which means the highest score that she can receive for that vault based on the difficulty value is a 9.6. All of the vaults since Sydney have been devalued in terms of their start value. Her second vault here.
This is a simpler vault. Actually, the start value of this vault is only 9.5.
This is a laid-out Sukahara with a full twist. She lands a mile from the horse, which shows good power. 9.075, the score for that vault, 9.137 for Chusovitina. Oh, we're going to love to see this vault. This is Yang Yun, the 16-year-old. Fifth place in the all-around at the Olympics in Sydney. I've watched her warm this up, Nadia. If it's anything like she warmed up, this is going to be spectacular. It's a handspring laid out front, which is not normally so unusual, but it's the way that she does it. Oh,
wow, beautiful. Beautiful vault. I haven't seen anything like that yet.
It really is difficult to do this vault with that kind of execution and technique. You often see the gymnast with bowed legs, bent knees. Look at how she thrusts her arms out to the side and holds that nice, tight, arch position.
This is a 9.6 start value. Let's take a look again of this vault. Legs are totally together. It's even artistic that the way she does this vault.
That really was one of the single prettiest moves I've ever seen in gymnastics. 9.25 is all. Now, it's a 9.6 start value, but I don't understand where those judges came up with deductions on that. Absolutely great technique. Well, Yang Yun, as I mentioned, was fifth in the all-around at the Olympics. She was also a medalist with the Chinese team, a bronze medalist on the bars as well. In fact, in the all-around, had she scored a little higher on the balance beam, she might have won the all-around gold. Only scored a 9.287 there. All right, now, the second of the two vaults. These will be average. This should be a lower start value vault.
This is a 9.5 start value vault. It's called a Phelps after the American gymnast G.C. Phelps, who did this vault first.
This vault used to be a 9.8 under the old code. This one's a little low in shorter rotation, so a 9.0 is a decent score for that vault. 9.125 for Yang Yun. When we come back, the final two vaulters, including the Olympic champion, Zamo. Today's gymnastics is brought to you by Celebrex. Talk to your doctor about Celebrex. And just two vaulters remaining in today's finals. Next up, the Olympic champion on this event, Zama Lochikova.
Wow, it was a great vault. A little to the right side. It's a start value of 9.90.
Boy, she lands a mile from the horse. And as usual, she hardly ever stops bouncing.
You're right, it's really high, but look, she made a little deviation on the right side.
Just on start values alone, she should win today's competition. This vault is a 9.9 start value. It was devalued from a 10 during the last four-year period. 9.5, her score. There are only a few vaults that are rated from a 10.0 start value. She's going to go for one here, a Yurchenko 2.5 twister.
Wow, she made it. This is a great vault. It was first performed by the Romanian gymnast Simona Amonar.
Let's take a look at what she does. She does a round off onto the board, back handspring onto the horse, and then she's going to do a layout with 2.5 twists. It's tough to spot that landing, a little shorter rotation, but right in line. So from a 10.0 start value, that gets a 9.55, her average 9.525. And the other gymnasts certainly admire her for being able to go for such a difficult vault. All right, this is Yana Komerskova, the final performer of the meet. The 18-year-old from the Czech Republic. She's an extremely powerful vaulter. At 5 feet, 5 inches tall, she's quite an athlete.
Wow.
Nice finish. This is the vault that was made popular by Lilia Podkopaeva from Ukraine.
It's a half into the horse, front pike with a half twist. Really online, great height, and good body position.
Great landing on that vault, a 9.7 start value for that. She knows how to really drill those landings into the floor. 9.25 the score. A couple of slight form errors. This second vault will be from a 9.6 start value. And again, she's great at those landings.
This is a front in pike with a half twist.
Slight form break on the pre-flight, so her score only a 9.15. Her average of 9.2 will place her in second behind the dominant Yelena Zamolochikova, and Yang Yung from China placed fourth. Well, it was a great day of gymnastics here at the Palais Omnisport de Bercy. The 2001 French International is over. A look at some new inspiring stars like Verona Vandeleur and some familiar faces from China, Russia, and Uzbekistan. For Nadia Komenich, I'm Bart Connor. Thanks for watching Gymnastics on Fox Sports Net.